Hi there guys, and welcome to Guitar Interactive Magazine. My name's Tom Quayle, and I've got a review for you here of quite an exciting product, actually. This was one of the products that was almost picked as products of show at NAMM 2012, this year in January. And this is the Sonuus Wahoo. And Sonuus, if you've never heard of them, are a company who are kind of well-renowned for their pitch tracking devices, which are utilized by musicians as MIDI, almost like a MIDI pickup. So you can plug your guitar into their USB units and they'll convert your audio signal into pitch or MIDI-based information. And they do so really, really well, actually. They've been very successful with that unit. And they're basically designed up in Scotland and built over in China, and very, very high quality units. Now they've taken that kind of grounding in sort of pitch recognition technology and expanded even further into this brand new kind of what you might call a wah stroke filter pedal. This is not your standard kind of filter pedal. This is really, really powerful, digitally controlled, but with analog filters. So you've got two analog filters in here, and they're the same kind of filters you would find on sort of analog vintage synthesizers. Really, really warm, fat sounding filters. But unlike those old filters where you had really complex kind of controls in order to make the units do what you wanted them to do, or say for instance you wanted to sequence the filters or run envelopes through them that were timed, it was very, very difficult. But the digital front end of this unit makes all of that very, very simple. Okay, so what you've got here is, as I say, a two filter unit, analog filters, with a front end digital control that you can control in various different ways. The unit can be used via the pedal on the top here, which is a very, I'll talk about the pedal in a minute actually, because there's some nice features they've built into this unit that mean it doesn't suffer from some of the problems you'll have with other wah and filter units. You can also control it using LFOs, and these are programmable LFOs. It's a low frequency oscillator. You can also use envelope filters on here, so basically you can control the filters by pick dynamics or by external controllers such as MIDI controllers. There's a USB port on the back that allows you to use MIDI, say from your DAW or from an external MIDI unit. And then you can also use their pitch recognition. So they've taken the technology from their MIDI units and brought them into the Sonuus Wahoo so that you can control the filters basically dependent on the pitch that you're playing, which is quite an exciting feature. This allows for some effects that are impossible on any other filter unit because only Sonuus have got that technology, that pitch tracking technology. You've got a lot of control over each of the filters. So those two filters, you can control the Q of the filters. You can have them as band pass or as high pass filters. You can shape the filters in lots of different ways. If you want to edit in high detail, i.e. you really want to crunch some numbers here, you really can. And because the unit's actually fairly complicated in that respect, Sonuus have offered a really high quality external kind of PC or Mac based control interface that you can use to edit the unit via USB, which is really, really, really cool. Okay, so if we just have a look at the unit itself, I'll just go down and show you the functions and I'll let you hear some of the sounds, which is obviously what you really want to hear. So the biggest feature of the pedal, obviously on the right hand side, is this huge, very, very, very well constructed aluminium control pedal, basically, which can control wah or can control the cutoff frequencies of the filters. You can pretty much assign it to any of the editable features of the pedal. Now, what's nice about this unit is it doesn't rely on the traditional build methods for say wah pedals that rely on like a pinion system where you're basically you have parts that can degrade over time and get noisy and scratchy, which is something that we've all experienced if we used kind of older wah pedals or older designed wah pedals. They sound great, but over time, and if they get gigged a lot, they get covered in dust and they get scratchy and you know, they wear out generally, basically. So the other type of pedal you can have is an optical pedal. And they suffer from their own problems. They can also get slightly noisy. They can be affected by bright stage lights, for instance. Now, this unit works on Sonuus's own design. They've basically invented a new system which gives you both a very, very smooth operation in the actual controller function and will never, ever wear out. At least that's their claim. Now, obviously, we can't demonstrate that in the review because we'd need to use it and gig it for at least a number of weeks, if not years, in order to test that claim. But I'm sure if Sonuus say the pedal will never wear out, it never will. And it's nice to know that they've thought about that element of things. And also, it's never going to get scratchy or noisy, which is great. Okay, moving on from the actual pedal itself, down on the left-hand side, we've got a large LED display, which will display the all the features you would need. So if you're editing a parameter, it gives you all the information you need. It'll show preset names, preset numbers, so on and so forth. So that updates depending on what you're doing. You've got a save button just here for saving up to 100 user presets, which is just a load. That's fantastic. Up and down preset buttons, and these function as parameter buttons as well. You've got level. So this will basically control your drive. This is how hard you drive the filters. Filter mix, so you've got two filters, so you can mix between them. Mix between dry and wet, and then your output level. Okay, and you can basically edit. I've got the unit in lock mode at the moment, which means that when I'm using the unit, I can't accidentally change any of the parameters. As soon as you unlock the unit, these controls will start to, you can utilize them much more fully. These are rotary controls. At the moment, it's telling me I'm locked, obviously, and they also push down to select different parameters. So moving on from there, we've got filter, the filter section, where we can select between filter 1 and 2, and then we can control the high and low Q frequencies of the filter, the high and low actual frequencies. The Q is the range of frequencies that you're adjusting. And then we've got the shape of the filter, or the curve of the filter, and then there's a mode feature underneath which will control basically what the pedal's doing, what your LFOs are doing, whether you're using envelopes to process the filters or pitch tracking, so on and so forth. So very, very versatile. Then at the bottom here we've got our true bypass switch, and the unit is true bypass, so once your signal enters the pedal it's not being processed if the unit is in the bypass mode. It's just going straight through to keep your signal intact. Okay, so really there's two ways you can use the unit. You can use it in a preset mode, in which case you've got 100 presets, and I'll demo some of those in a minute, or you can use it in editing mode. So just to really quickly show you editing mode, on the back of the unit there is a lock function, and I need to switch that off, which I do by moving it to the left there, and you'll see those LEDs come on. So now what I've got is I'm in preset number 0, which is basically just a real basic wah. Those kind of classic analog wah sounds, and it functions really, really well. I have to say the pedal feels superb. It's got a really nice range to it. It doesn't feel like you're being shortchanged in terms of range, and it's very, very, very smooth. And the range of that pedal can be edited basically so that you can actually choose where the frequency starts and stops. But at the moment, this is like a standard kind of wah. Very, very, very nice sound. And of course, because they're analog filters, they sound really, really warm, and they also sound pristine because they're controlled by a digital front end. And as you can hear, it's not particularly noisy at all. And bear in mind, we're running into the front of our amp here, not the effects loop. So it is running through the preamp of our amplifier. So any noise would be amplified, and I can't really hear a great deal at all. So that's great. That's really nice to know. Okay, so I could, for instance, if I just bring the pedal forwards so you guys can see, I could tap on the level button until I hit the drive function, and then I can increase the drive of the filters. Let's increase it all the way for the extreme kind of sound. You can hear now we've got more breakup in the actual filtered sound. Really, really nice wah sound, absolutely superb, but of course this is much more than a wah. Now any feature that I want to edit, so for instance if I leave the drive where it is and I want to increase the wet signal to 100%, now we're only hearing the wet signal. Let's bring that down again, just so you guys can hear this, now you're only hearing the dry signal. At which point obviously the pedal does nothing. Okay, so you can edit that very, very easily. Same goes for everything else. Basically, you can choose between filter 1 and 2. At the moment, we're on the shape function, so that's a band pass. Or we can have a low pass, okay? And then, basically, I can move to filter 2, go up to the high Q and change the, all of these parameters can be edited very, very, very easily, and then save within a preset. Same goes for the mode function. I can move between pedal mode. Actually, when I'm in pedal mode, I can select, if I just go back to pedal mode, I can select what the pedal does. okay, what's actually happening with the pedal, the LFO, type of LFO, so I can choose the pedal. Oops. And I need to set my dry mix back to somewhere a little bit higher. So lots of flexibility in terms of editing, really easy to use as well, I have to say, because this is a very deep unit, it's very complex. There's a lot of sound you can get from this. So to have fairly easy usability is great. I mean, the manual goes into a huge amount of depth about filters and what you can and can't control and how you can get certain sounds. We can do, for instance, the vowel sounds that, for instance, Steve Vai used to use very famously. So there's a lot of depth here, but if you just want to get straight in and edit the presets, it's actually very simple to do. So if I now go back to preset mode, if I just lock the unit again, okay, now I'm in preset mode. There's a few ways you can go into preset mode, but that's one of the ways. And let you hear a few of the presets. So there's a couple of ways I can change the presets. I can either use the up and down button here, which of course is only really suitable if you're not gigging or if you don't mind bending down to use the unit. But of course it's a floor unit, so there are other ways of changing the presets as well. So that's the first way. And again, all the first few presets are all kind of variations on a wah sound. Okay, now the other way I could change presets, and this is what I'm going to do for the rest of this review, is basically if I hold down the bypass button, you'll see it flash. Okay, now that means now that we're in the preset mode where we can actually change the presets using the foot pedal. If the controller pedal is all the way forwards, i.e. what they call toe down, and I press this button, I go up in the presets. If I have the heel down, I go down in the presets. So that's really, really useful. Okay, so I'm just gonna cycle through a few presets fairly randomly, to be honest, because we haven't had time to go through all of these. There's 100 of them, and just let you hear what they sound like. Okay, so here's preset number 5. Okay, let's just go through a few more. So let's go a little bit further up. Okay, preset 15. Now you're into more kind of vocal presets. So there was actually one here, which was really, if I go to 11. And you heard me use something similar to this in the intro demo for this pedal, where we've got the kind of vowel sounds. Again, really, really strong, very fat sounding filters here. What's really nice about this pedal, we haven't lost all the bottom end. A lot of these pedals, you'll lose all of the bottom end when you use the filter pedal. This is something bass players suffer from quite a lot with these kind of pedals. And they have to run a separate feed out to another amp so they don't lose their bottom end. This unit, you lose some of the bottom end. It's inevitable with these filters because of the way they work. They filter out certain frequencies. But you still keep a relatively good amount of bottom end here, which is quite nice to know. Certainly not creating a really thin sounding effect. And this pedal can be used by bass players as well. There's loads of bass presets on here. So let's cycle through a few more. Go up into the 20s and have a listen. So this is an envelope controlled filter. If I pick harder, we get more of the filter kicking in. So it's more like a touch wah, and again, they feel and respond really, really nicely. This is obviously really high quality kit that's going on here, really high quality electronics driving these analog filters, because that just that kind of responds incredibly well. So that's really, really cool. Let's cycle through a few more. So we'll go up into the 30s. And obviously I can't show you all of the presets, time doesn't permit, but of course if you get to go on one of these, you can check them all out. Again, more kind of filters based on envelopes. Okay, let's go through a few more. Cycle up into the 40s. Yeah. So that's obviously an LFO-based vocal kind of vowel-based filter. As you can hear, the LFO is running the filter response, basically. So it's like a rhythmic effect, okay? If we keep going. Okay, you can get as crazy as you want with this thing. More LFO-based filters up into the 50s. Okay, this is almost like a step sequencer, so you can do that too. We've got a step sequencer running through the different, sort of sequencing the filter, if you like, at different cue points, so on and so forth. So. Okay, again, tons of flexibility here. I mean, it's a really, really nice sounding and very versatile unit. We'll just go through a couple more so you really get an idea of how many are on here. Awesome, that's cool. Kind of inspirational, you know, a lot of these sounds. Moving forward, just a couple more. Whoa, that sounded weird. Again, more kind of envelope based stuff. And then finally, let's go into the 80s, have a listen to some of those. So huge amount of flexibility. I guess the real key features of this pedal are how good the filters sound. It really is going to be amongst the best sounding filter pedals that you can get. And obviously with the digital front end, you don't have to deal with kind of trying to work out where certain frequencies are for certain sounds, if you want to create certain vowels, for instance. In fact, the manual even tells you how to do that. They've really been very thorough with the manual. But you've got the control either via MIDI or the pedal or, you know, the LFOs or the envelope to control those filters in very, very creative ways. Fairly easily, to be honest. So yeah, I mean, all in all, very, very impressive. These are not the kind of effects that I personally would use, but I can imagine, you know, having been inspired by the pedal, writing tunes just based around the sounds that are available on this unit. So if you're looking for a little bit of extra inspiration, or you're looking for more sort of synth-like sounds, or just, you know, your creativity is not being fulfilled by the pedals you've got, the Sonuus Wahoo is an awesome pedal to get. On the other hand, if you're just looking for a really flexible, awesome sounding wah with a few extra features, also going to fulfill the bill in a very, you know, compact and good looking and sounding package. It's not crazy expensive. This is certainly not something that's going to completely break your bank account. And considering how well it's made, you know, you can't really go wrong. So there you have it, the Sonuus Wahoo. Hope you've enjoyed the review, and I will see you next time.